Thank you. As stated in Ecclesiastes 4:12, a threefold cord cannot quickly be torn apart. So how could we honor Jehovah in our married life? So let us call on Brother Rene Godinez. He will deliver the talk entitled Honorable Marriage in God's Sight.
Yeah, wedding occasions like this can be very pleasant. You see, Jason and Jandel looking at their best. Better yet, there is such joy and a happiness in their faces, as we can see. On this day, these smiles, their future seems full of hope and promise. Yes, wedlock is one of Jehovah's provisions for a lasting benefit for his earthly creature or children. It was designed for their benefit and happiness. In fact, perfect human Adam, when Jehovah created him, he has this need for a helper and a complement to fulfill Jehovah's commission to him to fill the earth and to subdue it. When Jehovah see or saw that Adam needs something, he did something, Jason. In the scripture, we can read that. If you have your Bible with you, please open it and follow along with me. In the book of Genesis, chapter 2, verse 21 and 22. So if you have your Bible with you, you can open it. Or if you have your tab with you or a mobile, you can open it. Okay. There it reads, Genesis chapter 2, verse 21 and 22. So Jehovah God caused the man to fall into a deep sleep. And while he was sleeping, he took one of his ribs and then closed up the flesh over its place. And Jehovah God built the rib that he had taken from the man into a woman, and he brought her to the man. You see, Jehovah there did something. Jehovah used a rib of Adam in creating the first woman. And it could have impressed on the first human the closeness of their union. At that time, Jason, Eve was the closest possible relative of Adam. And after this wedding, Jandel will be the closest relative to you. And when Jehovah designed that wedding in Eden, the provision was to be a permanent union. In fact, if you try to go further, reading on that same chapter 2, verse 24, it reads, 2:24, there it says, that is why a man will leave his father and his mother, and he will stick to or remain with his wife, and they will become one flesh. You see, stick to or remain with his wife. In novels and movies, a marriage often provides the happy ending that people crave. In real life, though, when Jehovah instituted that marriage, it was not an ending, but it was a beginning, the start of something.